welcome to this year's Common Avenue Holiday Special. This year, we'll be taking a fantastic journey with a reading of the classic, The Holidays Are This and That. It's summer, and Christmas is far away. But one lad is glad. He likes it that way. It's not that he hates the holiday cheer. It's not that he hates the eight reindeer. It just so happens he loves the season, and he goes to extremes without any reason.
Yeah, I like it when the girls stop by in the summer. New kids on the block had a bunch of hits. Chinese food, summertime sick, and I think it's fly when girls stop by for the summer, for the summer.
It's the most wonderful time with the
Just walking in the neighborhood, thought I'd stop by and say hello.
Ah, man, well, when was the last time you were here?
It's been a while.
Would you like some eggnog? Maybe some hot chocolate?
No, thanks.
Ah, man.
You know what, man? I remember the last time you were here. You and Judy came by, we were playing Pinochle and Parcheesi, and we had a great time. Remember that? It was so fun.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
Good times, man.
I remember that. Mm. Judy and I just broke up.
Oh, man. I'm sorry. You guys seem like so in love. What happened?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Okay.
Let's talk about why your apartment is decorated for Christmas in the middle of the summer.
Well, actually, Charlie, I represent both Hanukkah and Kwanzaa in my decorating.
I know. I could see that. But why is it, you know, 6 months before we have...
6 months? The holidays are only 6 months away? I only have 6 months to prepare? I have gifts to buy? I've got gifts to write? I have a tremendous amount to do.
Jason, what's the matter with you?
Last year I made a fool of myself. I saw myself on your TV show. I didn't capture the essence of the holidays. And this year I'm doing something about it. I'm doing it.
Jason, this is a little insane.
Charlie, you don't understand. I know you're trying to, but you don't understand. But I really am sorry. I have a lot to do now. Gotta get ready, it's only 6 months away. Maybe I can call you, we can go holiday shopping or something. Along the way, I've got a lot to do. I'm really sorry, so much to do.
Jason was panicked and moved with a dash, tossed his dear friend out right on the grass. Poor sad Charlie, with thoughts of a girl, stomach all twisted, he thought he would hurl.
Hello?
Good morning! How's Santa's little helper doing?
To be honest, I'm feeling pretty crappy today. I just can't stop thinking about Judy.
Well, why don't you come out holiday shopping with me, you know? Take your mind off her for a little while.
First of all, I'm not going shopping until November. And secondly, I'm just too depressed right now.
I wish things were different. I wish she could feel my pain. I wish she could feel how cold I feel.
I wish she could feel how lost I am.
Oh, she'll feel lost. Yeah, but listen, until that day comes, why don't you just come out holiday shopping with me?
I'm just gonna stay home today, I think.
All right, buddy, I'll talk to you later. Feel better, okay? Bye.
Hello?
Charlie! Hey, it's Jason. How you doing today?
It's been a rough couple months, but I'm feeling better. I definitely am.
Yeah. And I'm sorry I didn't call you back about the holiday shopping. I just wasn't into it yet.
That's fine.
Yeah, want to go holiday shopping today?
No, man. It's still a little too early.
Okay. All right, then. I'll call you next month.
Okay.
All right. Okay, bye. Right on time, Judy. Right on time. Are you kidding me? You've got to shop sometime.
All right, you know, I promise next month that we'll go shopping together, okay? Jason, have you been shopping this whole time?
Of course I have. I have so many people to buy for. In fact, I gotta go right now because I have some other gifts to wrap.
All right, man. Be careful. Don't bankrupt yourself.
Don't worry about me. I'll be fine. Bye.
That ought to tide you over. Fragile? Very fragile. Hey Charlie, it's Jay. Hey, how you doing? It's been a month. Are you ready to go Christmas shopping yet?
I am a man of my word. Can you pick me up at around 2 on Saturday?
Sounds great. I'll be there. All right, bye.
With the box all packed and the girl squeezed in. It is at this moment where the journey begins.
We'll be right back. Jason. Who is all this stuff for? I mean, no offense, but you don't have that many friends. Like this. Okay? Who is this for?
That actually, this is for the lady who made my coffee yesterday. Really nice lady.
And this? Who is this for?
That's for my elementary school bus driver, actually. You know, I gotta check to see if she's alive still. And her address. I need her address. You know what, Charlie? See, if I didn't start shopping earlier, you know how screwed I'd be?
Jason, are you telling me that you are buying gifts for every person you've ever known or met?
Duh.
That's an incredibly sweet gesture, Jason, but totally impractical. How can you afford all this?
Charlie, don't worry about my financial situations, all right? I don't mean to sound rude, but you need to mind your own business.
Your total is $1,124.17.
No problem.
How would you like to pay for that?
Credit, please.
I'm sorry, your card was declined.
Really? Okay, thought I had money. Charlie, do you think maybe you could buy this for me? I spent my last $150, I think, on shipping out a present.
Alaska? I'm in Alaska?
Okay, I'll tell you what. Why don't you pick out the five most important gifts out of this and I'll buy those for you.
Charlie, I can't buy the mailman a gift and then completely ignore the trash man. It doesn't work. You can't do that.
Okay, all right. Is anything here for a relative?
Well, not really. There's something for my brother's girlfriend.
Okay, grab that one. And beyond that, is there anything here for people you see every day?
Yeah.
Grab those right now.
Okay. Caution tape. Got the mallet. All right. And, oh. These are for people I see every day.
Great. Well, you got your five there. Okay, so I'm sorry, but we're just going to take these five items right here, okay?
But everything's like...
You know, Jason, the holidays aren't about buying gifts for every person you know or meet.
They're not?
No. The holidays are about buying gifts for people you love. And you don't have to get a gift for every acquaintance out there. And you know something else, Jason? Sometimes Sometimes you may not have any money at all, and that's okay too.
Really?
You know why?
No, why?
It's a gift from the heart. It means way more than something from some stores. Write a poem. Make a card. Make a necklace out of macaroni, or record a song. It doesn't even matter. As long as it comes from the heart. Love. Love is the essence of the holidays, Jason. Not money.
You're right, Charlie. From now on, my gifts are going to be about love and compassion, not money.
Who's there? I have a gun. Who's there? Oh. I'm so hungry. I don't know why Jason would do this to me. I'm gonna die out here. Wait. You have supplied me.
Jason has learned about gifts and giving. Well, poor little Judy is worried about living. But tomorrow will be the ultimate test as Jason tries to make a present that is best. And we will see Judy try to survive and try to make it home for the holidays alive. Join me tomorrow for the second installment of our epic journey. Thanks for watching, and happy holidays. Hello, and welcome to part two of the Common Avenue Holiday Special. Let's see where we left off. Here we are. When last we checked, our story had turned. Jason was broke, and Judy was burned. But today is a new day, and more is to come. Will Jason make right? And will Judy succumb?
It's cold and you're alone. Are you not near a telephone? I'm in your heart right now. I just ate a chunk of cow and I'll be home for the holidays. So would you just stay?
Awesome.
Hello?
Charlie, it's Jay.
What's up, Jason?
Hey,
I just wanted to call and thank you for what you did for me yesterday.
I really appreciate it.
Well, that's what friends are for. We do nice things for each other. We teach each other about life, right?
What are you doing right now?
Nothing. Nothing at all. Nothing at all. I'll tell you what I'm not doing. I'm not painting my toenails.
Well,
Would you be interested in helping me write a holiday song for my friends and family? You see, I have this friend Dave, and he owns a recording studio, and he said that
Christmas songs make big money. And I'm kind of interested in this religious chick, you see. And if I do this, she might date me. So why don't you come down here and record your little holiday track, and maybe I'll get lucky.
Sounds a little creepy, but yeah, sure, I'll help you.
All right, the sooner the better. Meet me at 24 Winthrop Street at 1 o'clock, okay? And hurry, because Charlie, the music is in me. It's beautiful music, and it needs to be released from my soul. All right, buddy. All right, bye.
Thank you.
around here?
Nope.
Well, do you know where we are?
I reckon we're in Alaska, ma'am.
I knew it.
There, there.
A man shipped me in a box to Alaska. I survived on salted crackers and water. I need to get home, and I don't know what to do.
Well, I reckon I may be able to help you, ma'am.
You'll help me? Thank you, kind sir. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
I reckon if you head off that way, you'll find an old abandoned airplane hangar. And that hangar's an airplane. And if you're too scared to fly, I reckon there's a bike.
So kind. And thank you for these life-giving berries you have bestowed upon me.
I'm gonna make you some Christmas magic, baby. This stuff is gonna blow your mind.
The Lord really appreciates that.
Yeah, I'm sure he does.
So it's this weekend, basically. Saturday. Middle of the woods, it'll be terrific. I'll give you my email address and walk up that way.
All right, people, come on, let's go. Let's do this. Everybody out. Come on. Out of the room. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on, people. Let's go. Time is money. Time is expensive. Let's do it. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Hold on. All right, listen. I like you, okay? And I think you're a good guy.
I like you.
Okay. Listen. If you screw this up, if it doesn't sound like Jesus himself is singing it, I will personally give you the beating of a lifetime. Do you understand?
Yeah, but I've never recorded a song before, and it's like...
I don't care what you have to do. You make the song great. You make the song special.
Okay.
You make that woman out there like me.
Okay.
You make me money. You understand? Huh? Huh? Mm-hmm. You understand?
Okay,
good.
I'm feeling it.
Good, you feel it. You understand.
Okay.
Good.
Jason is faced with quite a situation. But will he act without hesitation?
Doing is so special, lending studio time to your friend for free, and it's for such a good cause.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, you're a good man. You're a really good man.
I'm a good man. I'm a good man.
All right, everybody, let's make some beautiful music, all right? Everybody get your places. I'm gonna roll sound. Here it comes. We're rolling.
It's the holidays, those special days, where everything just seems right. And I wish you the best every day of your life.
You're a shining star, you drive a car, you wear that dress just right. And I'm wishing you happy holidays tonight.
All right, cut, cut, cut. What was that? What was that?
Well, I was just saying it like you told me to.
Well, it wasn't good enough, all right? It just wasn't up to par. You know what? Get out. You're off the team.
But...
Get out. Just get out. This song needs to be perfect, and you, my friend, are far from perfect. All right. Who would like to sing that part? Who's gonna sing that part? You. You will sing that part. Come here.
What's his problem?
I have no idea.
All right, Dave, I'm really sorry about that, you know, dealing with the amateurs and all. You know, we'll start over.
Great. Let's keep our spirits up. Here we go. And go.
It's the holidays, the special days, where everything just seems right. And I wish you the best every day of your life.
You're a shining star, you drive a car, you wear that dress just right. And I wish you a happy holiday tonight.
All right, cut. Are we going to do this right? Because if we're not going to do it right, then we shouldn't do it at all.
Jason, don't you think you're being a little harsh? I mean, we're just doing the best we can.
We didn't come here for this. We came to celebrate the holiday spirit. Ashley, let's take off.
Wait, I'm sorry. I didn't mean...
It's too late.
That's it. I've had it. I'll take it off. You better never call me again or I will kick you in the head, all right?
You are a disgrace. To think that I was being a good guy by letting you use my studio. You want to be ashamed of yourself.
You know, Jason, you're never gonna earn your wings by acting like that. You better look at the sky and pray.
I'm doomed. This is like last year, but worse.
Your heart was in the right place, Jason, and then it all just fell apart. What happened?
Dave told me that if I didn't make the perfect song, that he would hurt me.
Jason, lying isn't gonna solve your problems. Dave seemed like a great guy, and even if he did say that, you didn't have to do what you did.
I guess so.
Music is about cheer and togetherness. The spirit of the holiday song is that we all join our voices, as imperfect as most of ours are,
yeah,
in songs that capture the magic of the holiday season. No one should ever be excluded from the shared joyous experience of holiday tunes. It is a right that we should all value and share.
I wanted to in life. I never really loved a man.
I never even got to hold my own child. I never even got to tell my family how much they meant to me. But if any of you exist, please help me. I promise, if you guys get me home, I will always value my life. I will always be kind to others. I want to feel love. I want to be truly happy. And if I make it home, I will never take anything I have for granted. So please. Open the door, please. Life, and I will not waste it.
Charlie, I think I'll ever have a chance at love.
Why are you worried about it?
I just feel like no one could love me. I seem to always screw things up.
It's a big world out there, Jason. A world filled with potential love for all of us. The best thing you can do is be proactive. Try to date. Try to love. Get out there. Make it happen. And yeah, who knows? Maybe the love of your life will just show up unexpectedly. Love always happens when you're not looking for it.
Thanks, Charlie. Thanks a lot.
It's getting late, maybe we should take off.
Yeah, okay. Maybe we should take off.
Judy is flying way up above, while Jason feels squashed, just like a bug. Tomorrow may bring love and devotion, or it may be more damn commotion. Join me tomorrow for part 3 of our epic journey. Thanks for watching, and happy holidays! Welcome to part 3 of the Common Avenue Holiday Special. Let's see where we left off, huh? Ah! Jason is somber and not doing well. He dreams of a romance that is very swell. Judy is soaring high in the sky. Her feelings are positive. She feels really high.
'Cause now it's Christmas and I want everything. I just can't wait. Christmas.
Hello? Is it me you're looking for?
I can see it in your eyes. I can see it in your smile. Hello?
Hey, Charlie, it's Jay.
I just wanted to call and thank you for what you did yesterday. It really made me motivated to, like, find romance and
to be a better guy. So thank you.
I'm your best friend. That's what I'm supposed to do, right?
You're a good friend, man. I appreciate it.
What are you doing today?
I'm working at the rink at 2 today. Why?
Well, I've got this little holiday charity I'm working on that I thought maybe you could
help me with.
Wow, that is really great. Yeah, sure. Maybe I'll come by after work. I'll call your cell phone, okay?
All right, that'll be great.
Yeah.
All right.
I'll fly by after work.
All right. Bye.
Merry Christmas! Please give to the needy. A dollar may not mean much to you, but it sure means a lot to me. Oh, Merry Christmas! Please give to the needy. A dollar may not mean much to you, but it sure means a lot to me.
Hello, please, I'm in great need. Thank you.
Oh, a little spare change for the needy, ma'am?
Well, how can I say no to you, Santa? Oh. You've always been so good to me over the years.
Oh, you wouldn't leave without sitting on Santa's lap, would you? Oh, you wouldn't leave without giving Santa your phone number, would you?
Wouldn't?
I know where you live, little girl. Santa just got his bell rung. Oh, crap.
Damn. Oh, my God. I love him. 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 I love him.
Oh, yes. Hello?
Jason, hey.
It's Charlie.
Hey, Charlie.
I'm just calling to see how it's going.
Yeah, actually, it's not going that well.
Yeah, I haven't met one girl yet.
What do you mean you haven't met a girl yet? I thought you
were doing something for charity.
Duh. I'm doing a fake charity?
You set up a fake charity to meet women?
Oh, gotta go.
Oh, hello! Do you have any spare change?
I'm sorry, I don't have any change.
Oh, my, does Santa check your pockets?
Pervert.
Oh, no. Oh, crap.
She was fine. Damn fine.
Oh my God, it's like totally no problem. You are way too cute to be hitchhiking out in the cold. Where are you heading?
Well, I'm trying to get to Boston, but you can just drop me off anywhere that's on the way.
Oh my god, this is totally random. I'm uber excited. I'm going to Boston too.
I can't believe it. That's great.
Like, I know. So what are you doing here anyway?
Well, someone shipped me in a box to Alaska. Then I stole a plane, and then I flew the plane, and then I landed the plane, and then I got in your car. And now we're driving to Boston.
What's the matter, Santa?
I've had a bad day.
Oh, well, cheer up. It's the season of cheer, my dear.
Hey, wait up. Come here for a second.
Yes, Santa?
I'm not really Santa.
Really? It's too bad. I've always had a thing for Santas.
My name's Jason.
Oh, well, hi. I'm Courtney. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I know this might be a little upfront, but I was wondering if maybe you would like to go out or something?
Maybe, if Santa asked me.
Would you care to go out for a thing with Santa?
Oh, yes, I'd love to.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you like ice skating?
I love it.
My friend works at a rink down the street. Would you like to go now?
Yeah.
Okay,
that'd
let's
be cool.
Go. All right.
Charlie!
Hey.
Charlie.
What's up, Jason?
Hey, this is my new friend, Courtney. Courtney, this is my good friend, Charlie.
Hi, Charlie. Nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you as well. So, what are you guys up to?
We are here to skate.
Great. The sizes?
Men's size 14.
Women's 9.5.
Here you are.
Courtney, why don't you go put those on over there, and I'll be over in a couple minutes?
Okay.
So, how'd that happen?
Just happened, man. It's like you said, love always comes when you least expect it.
That's great, man.
Oh, hey. You think in a few minutes you might be able to throw this track on for me?
Sure, no problem.
Charlie, please report to the ladies' bathroom for a big cleanup.
Okay, that's embarrassing.
All right, remember the CD, man. Thanks.
Oh my god, you like flew a plane?
Yeah, it was incredible.
So now what? Are you gonna like press charges?
No. I don't care what's happened to me. I just want to get home to the man that I love.
That is like so totally super mega forgiving of you. You sound like totally hungry. I, like, have this burger if you want it. I'm like, totally obese right now, so you can have it.
Thank you.
Oh. Thanks for coming here with me.
Thanks for having me.
I got a surprise for you.
Hey guys.
Hey.
So, did you have fun?
Yeah, it was awesome.
Great. I'm glad you had a good time.
Thank you.
Hey, that'll be $12.50.
$12.50?
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm paying.
If you want to pay, that's fine. I'm all about equality.
But you're paying with the charity money.
Well, it's not really charity money. I set up a fake charity to meet women, so technically, this is my money.
You set up a fake charity to meet women? I thought you were different. I thought you cared about the needy people. You're just like all the rest of the guys.
Listen, listen, Courtney. I really like you, okay? I mean...
Too bad. I won't date a guy who has the nerve to rob people on the holidays. You're a bad man, Jason, a bad man.
Little nasty girl. Yo, man, you see that?
Damn. So you, like, Omega love this guy.
I was in the dark before. I took life for granted. I took him for granted. But that was the old me. Now I just can't wait to get home and hold him, and I can't wait to thank him for what he's done for me.
You're, like, head over stilettos for this guy.
He's truly a man. You got it, don't give me a call. I'm falling like the
every time I feel alone, I can blame it on you, and I do. Oh, you got me like a loaded gun.
Can I come in?
I guess, come in.
Say, that was really, really bad. You crossed the line. You can't lie and steal any time, but especially not on the holidays.
I know, but I was so desperate to not be alone on the holidays. I would have done anything.
Love will come, Jay. You gotta be patient. And just be thankful for the friends and family that you have right now that love you. Right now. Someday, the right girl will come along.
How do you stay so positive? Aren't you sad about not having Judy over the holidays?
She'll be here. You hear me? She will be with me, okay? She will be with me, you mother pig! She will be with me! You hear me? She will be with me! Just kidding. Okay. Sure, yeah, sometimes I get upset, you know, about the lack of love in my life, but I refuse to let that keep me down.
You're right, Charlie. So was Courtney. And because of it, I lost a really, really great girl.
Listen. Tomorrow night's my annual holiday party. Why don't you make a real effort to just be a good guy? Be the Jason that we all know and we all love, that we're all fond of. Jason, you are a good guy. Can you do that?
Yeah. I can do that. I'm gonna make the best of this holiday season. Charlie, tomorrow is my fresh start.
So do you, like, have any plans when you get back?
I'd love to shower, seeing it's been days, but I don't know if I'll have time. I have a very special party to go to.
Oh my god, I love parties.
You wanna come? You can meet my man.
Oh my god, that'd be, like, totally spontaneous. I would totally dig that.
Judy and Marsha have become good friends. Well, Jason and Courtney have come to an end. Yeah, whatever. Charlie has given Jason one last chance. But will Jason get the very last dance? With all that's gone wrong and all that's a matter, will Jason pull through? Or will his hopes just splatter? Join me tomorrow for part four of our epic journey. You won't want to miss the exciting conclusion. Thanks for watching, and happy Excuse me, I'm a little dry over here. Can you... Yeah.
I was thinking the same thing. Welcome to part four, the final, thank goodness, installment of the Common Avenue Holiday Special. Let's see where we left off. Oh, Judy and Marsha speed down the street to get to Judy's love, whom she dies to meet. Jason is hoping for one more big break. He needs to do it for holiday's sake. Tonight is his party, and Charlie's on duty. But what is to happen when he sees Judy?
Soon it will be Christmas.
Oh, hey, come on in.
What's up?
What are you doing here so early? It's 9 a.m.
I just wanted to get a jump on the decorating and stuff. I brought over a few things.
Oh, great, great. Thanks a lot. This is a good start, Jason. A good start.
From Boston?
Probably like 7 hours.
Let's pull over. I can buy some deodorant. Then we can take an hour nap and still make it to the party by 10.
Oh, thank God. My eyes are heavy like a fat girl's. Ugh, you do totally reek.
Merry Christmas, Julie. I miss you too. Oh.
Oh, yeah, I'm so glad that get him off me,
please! Yeah.
Oh, you totally smell like you were trapped in a small box for days.
Judy, isn't it like totally weird that we met like this?
Yeah. This whole adventure has just been so amazing. I really feel blessed.
Judy?
Yes?
I want to be in love like you are. You seem totally Omega 14 happy.
Well, maybe you'll meet someone at the party and fall in love.
Yeah, maybe he'll be like totally sweet and we can like hook up in a really romantic way.
Maybe.
Okay, now we're just gonna go over a few ground rules here, Jason. What you see here, these are people.
Oh my God, Judy, I like just talked to this trucker guy. We're totally an hour away from Boston.
Now these people...
Chinese.
No, they're at a party.
What's wrong? You look a little nervous. Are you gonna, like, upchuck in my car or something?
No, I'm fine. I'm just a little scared.
Rule number one. Never insult a guest. People like to be treated nice. Treat them as you would like to be treated if you were at a party.
I'm worried if my love will be reciprocated.
Look, he would be a total loser if he didn't love you. I mean, I love you and you're, like, totally smelly and gross.
Rule number two. Never touch a woman in an inappropriate way. This means no groping, no tugging, no licking.
Oh, thanks, Marsha.
I would, but you said I might meet a guy tonight, and, you know.
Okay, but what about, like, a congratulatory pat on the rump?
No. Bad Jason, no.
No.
Naughty!
Jason, what are you doing over here?
I'm just sitting here trying not to cause any problems.
Well, can't you have a little fun without causing any problems?
Well, I'm a little bit nervous, as my whole holiday season is riding on this one single event.
You know what you need?
No, Charlie. What? What do I need?
You need a little drink. Just a little something to help you relax. Take the edge off.
No, I really shouldn't have a drink sometimes.
Jason, Jason. Just take a drink, a little sip, and relax. Remember, you're a good guy. You'll be fine.
Okay.
All right, I'll see you guys over there, okay? Hey, man. Hey, have you guys met my friend Jason?
No, I've never met him.
Can't say that I have. Let me go get him real quick. Hold on. You're going to love him. He's a great guy.
Jason. Why don't you come on over? Meet a couple of my friends.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Guys, this is my good friend
Hi,
Jason.
Hi, my name is Jason. Who are you?
Hi, my name is... Oh, that's good.
My brother has a sister named that name. That's awesome. That guy.
Guy?
Guy.
Yeah.
You?
I think I see it in your eyes.
You and me.
We're best friends. I gotta go potty. Peace. Yeah. Hey, sugar, lips.
One question.
I think your friend's a little drunk.
I was wondering.
Wait, what happened?
He grabbed my butt and he's asking me out and he won't leave me alone.
I didn't do nothing.
Okay, did you do that?
No, I didn't.
Yes, he did.
Let me just talk to him for a second, okay? I'm sorry about this.
She's
I'll just
got
talk
it,
to him.
Though.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
What'd you do to her?
Nothing. I didn't do anything.
Did you do what you said you did?
No, I didn't.
Because if you did, you can't do that to women. You know that, don't
Charlie,
you?
Charlie, I don't know this, but you're not the boss of Jay.
Are you drunk?
Whatever.
You're drunk, aren't you?
No.
All right, you know what I want you to do? I want you to go out there right now and apologize to her, and I want you to be sincere about it, okay?
Okay.
You can't even stand up straight.
Fine.
You can't even
I can
stand
tell
up
her
straight.
What's going on. Let's go. Watch out. Listen. Okay? You hear this? Hey, sugar. Hi. Listen, okay. I'm really sorry about what...
Hey, dude, seriously.
No, seriously, you need to stop.
No, listen.
Okay,
you
know what?
I got it.
I got it.
You got him?
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Thanks.
You
sorry.
Got
hey,
something.
Hey, Jason, come here.
You
come
got
here.
It.
Listen. Listen. Listen, I'm sorry, man. You blew it. And I'm gonna have to ask.
I'll get it.
Oh my God, Judy.
Uh-oh.
Judy. Jason?
Jason, I'm in love with you.
What?
What?
She said she's like totally in love with him.
What do you mean you're in love with him?
Jason mailed me in a box to Alaska with a sleeve full of salted crackers and a bottle of water.
It's true.
You mailed Judy in a box to Alaska?
Merry Christmas, man. Merry Christmas.
How did you mail Judy in a box to Alaska? Why did you mail Judy in a box to Alaska?
I don't know. So dope.
Jason gave me the greatest holiday gift ever. He showed me the kindness of the world, and for that, I will always love him. Jason, do you love me?
Sure I love you. Sure I love you.
Okay. Hi, everyone. I'm Marcia.
Nice to meet you, Marcia.
Hey, Marcia. Welcome to the most messed up holiday party ever. Came here for an apology, you can forget about it.
You know I did it for you, right?
Did what for me?
Send Judy in a box to Alaska?
What does that do for me?
She was hurting you, man. I wanted her as far away from you as possible. So I kidnapped her, put her in a box, and I shipped her to Alaska.
You realize that's messed up.
Sure, in retrospect I do. But at the time I thought it was a good idea. I love you, man. All I wanted to do was make you happy. Man, you're my best friend.
Why does she love you? I just don't get it.
I gave Judy a second chance. A great gift. Will you give me a second chance, Charlie?
Do you love her?
She loves me. I don't really know her that well.
Are you gonna stay with her?
Probably. Charlie, she loves me. She loves me. I'm really sorry, man. I'm really sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
All right. Now open your gift, man. Open it. Come on. La 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 la
In the end, it all worked out. Friends remained friends, and none did pout. Judy and Jason made out every day, while Charlie and Marcia rolled in the hay. Things were joyous on this day of cheer, and Jason looks forward to the next holiday year. It was quite a journey for all of us, and I'm glad it worked out. Thanks for joining us this holiday season. Good night.
Progressive, single white female, 37. Great smile. You know when it says great smile, doesn't it?
Jason, what are you doing over here? Jason, what are you doing?
I totally blanked on my line. I was just like, I was thinking something else and then something. Lose control.